All right, guys, here we go. Season mode. Here we are. See, my, this one cannot be because he's already been through it. So here's my copy. So here we go. And he's just finding the way he is. So yeah, it's kind of low on the that, but hey, it's okay. We'll build up the rest of the way, just like here comes the pain. Blech. Left with no title. Oh, Vince McMahon. Okay, I'm ready for the next one. Send him in. Him in. So you go by the name of Hitman. Interesting. According to this report put together by my WWE scouts, I see that you have just recently graduated from wrestling training. Top of your class. Yes, sir. They said I was a natural and had a bright future ahead of me. I figured that the only place with making my mark is right here in WWE. So here I am. Well, that's fine. But let's not get ahead of ourselves just yet. You see, you may be here at the WWE offices, but I won't say that you are in the WWE. At least not yet. I realize that where you came from, you were a big fish in a small pond. But now that you're under my roof, you're going to go back to the beginning and pebble a nobody being okay. Sorry. At least until such time as we feel that you're truly WWE material. Until such a time comes that we feel you're ready for the next step towards the spotlight. It won't be easy. You feel like you are paying your dues all over again because that's exactly what you'll be doing. You may have been hot stuff where you just came from, but around here you're nothing until you put it in your time and improving yourself. If you can't abide by that, then you've got no chance in hell of making it in the WWE. And if you fail, I've got just a list of pages long of men and women such as yourself who are willing to make it to the extreme sacrifices necessary to succeed in this business in the WWE. So after all that, are you certain that you will still want to give the WWE a try? Are you sure this is for you? Are you certain you have what it takes? More than ever, Mr. McMahon, I know this is right for me, and I won't let you down. Great. That's the right answer. If you work hard, polish your skills, and do what you're told, you'll do fine. And if you do that, all that, you definitely won't let me down. Awesome. When do I start? Will it be on Raw or SmackDown? Will I have manager? Can I meet Trish? Hold on just a second there, Hitman. Your first assignment is going to be in our WWE development program. You will have some matches there where our WWE trainers can take a look at you up close and to help your efficiency build to analyze your skills and a ring technique. It won't be glamorous or easy for you, but if you can prove yourself there, you'll be likely be promoted to some appearances on WWE Sunday Night Heat. If you prove yourself on Heat, well then time may come when you'll be assigned to the Raw or SmackDown brand rosters, and at that time, I'll be the only too happy to present you where your first WWE contract. I trust that you find all this acceptable. You bet. Thanks, Mr. McMahon. Fine. So I accept you to report to WWE Developmental immediately. I'm certain that they'll want to get you involved in some tune-up matches right away. I wish you good luck. Oh, my throat's a little dry for saying all that. Okay. Yes, yeah, this is how I'm gonna. There you go. That's way to build it up. Okay, so here we go. Yeah, guys, I'll do 4 each. So, like, kind of like a month. So, fourth week of March. Show 1. Report to WWE Developmental. I'm Jonathan Goetschman. Hey, excuse me. I saw you walk in. You are, my name is Hitman. Hitman, right, well, in any case, there's no need for me to introduce myself. I'm sure you already know Jonathan Goetschman, the coach. Now, everyone knows that the coach has done just about everything that there is to do in this company. Commentary, interviewing, even wrestling. And I'm the best there is. I've won pay-per-view matches, and I've even been the protege to the great Eric Bischoff. So as you can imagine, there is no segment that Mr. McMahon himself would not personally entrust to the coach. And that's why when the WWE needed an extra talent scout to evaluate a new branch of up and coming rookies in the beginning stages of their careers, they turn to me. So do yourself a favor, always listen to what the coach has to say. I can make careers or I can break them, so it pays you to follow my instructions. Got it? Sure. Okay, great. So if you got your first degree developmental match coming up right now. If you want the coach to be impressed, just go out there and win it. Yeah, coach, you're just another wannabe. He was on ESPN, but I don't know what happened to him now. I don't know what he's doing now, but he actually was on ESPN for a little while. Here we go, first match. House show. Yeah, Ric Flair theme, I don't care. Who's my opponent? Who is that? Looks like I just hit another jobber. Joey Rock, Trania. Special conditions, none. Okay, just gotta win the match. Joey Rock. Okay. Well, Trania, so yeah, it's a jobber. What up, jobber? Mess with me. Nah, I spoke too soon. Nice. Oh, RKO. Oh, Hitman loves his moves. I don't want to win that way. Yeah, that's right. It was by accident. On the pinfall. Oops. Well, you've read that one. Hit the ref. That's mission. Well, he almost tapped out. Now it's time for the finisher. Dang right. Jackhammer time. Bam. It's over.
1, 2.
Just like that. J-Rock, go back, you jobber. Awesome. We just got 12 attribute points. And I'll kind of just build them up each match. We used to be every month on the Here Comes the Pain, but I'll do it after every match, so. Yep. First, we have April, show 2, 5 minutes. So, probably one match in 5 minutes, probably means. I've got to admit, you showed me something out there in your last match. But don't kid yourself. It's going to take a lot more than that to impress the coach. So for your next match, you not only do you need to win, but I also want to be sure that you can finish off an opponent quickly if you're asked to. So have you got 5 minutes to win your next match? And I'll deck you. So again, said that Joy Rock guy or somebody else. Oh my gosh! Looks like it looks like Sid Vicious. He reminds me of. But Sid Vicious does not do that. He's doing a big public pump of impression. That's wrong. Sid Vicious that does the big pump of pump. I don't think so. Yeah, Sid Vicious would look like, I should say. No problem. I'll finish this scrub off in 5 minutes. He's over muscled though. I think he's been taking steroids, WWE. You got 5 minutes to defeat your opponent. Brad Brixton. Trainee. Nah. Okay, here we go. Oh. Took that one. Oh, shoot, I should have blocked that there. Okay, you're finished.
One, two, three.
Took care of that. Less than 5 minutes. Go back to the gym, Brad. Two more matches, then we'll switch to another part, so... Show 3, meet Mr. Heyman. Oh, Paul Heyman. Mr. Heyman, I've been waiting to meet you for a long time. My name is Mr. Heyman. This is the new guy I was telling you about. Please let me introduce. It's him, man. Like I said, Mr. Heyman, it's an honor to meet a former WGM such as yourself. I'm sure it is. Coach, he doesn't look like much, but you can't always judge a book by its cover. I'm here watching some of your development talent tonight. What we can't expect from you. He is still a little rough around the edges, but he does have a few interesting moves. Well, as you know, a man such as myself is always looking for performers with a little attitude and patchy. Sorry, guys, can't read that right. So in your match tonight, why not show off some style? That's a great idea, Mr. Heyman. Hey, man, in your match tonight, why don't you show Mr. Heyman your finishing move? I've done that. Only just to make sure he notices it. Do it twice. You want me to hit my finisher twice? Okay, no problem. Yeah, no problem. I have no problem with that. I mean, a kung fu guy, I think. You will need to hit your finishing move twice. Okay, so I'll just build up two finishers. And so Wing Su Ya. Or it's Wing Su Ye or whatever. It's just all I know, he's a jobber. I like that. Su Ye. DDT up top rope. Boom. So I can't turn him around right now. There's a sharpshooter. Ankle lock. One more time for a good measure for Mr. Hammond. Go back to Japan. Go back to your home country, put it that way. And train more. What's that sound in the background? Just makes me wonder. Okay. Let's see what the final show is before we switch to another part. B07. Oh, Matt Hardy. Hey, Matt, I want you to meet Matt Hardy. He's here in the WWE developmental for a little while to rehab his right leg. He strained some ligaments back on Raw a few weeks ago. Nice to meet you, Matt. All you can call me Matt Hardy VO7 since I'm only at about 70% right now. Yeah, I'm at about 70%. So the trainers want me to work a few matches down here to make sure I'm good to go on TV. That's where you come in, man. You and Matt are going to have a match tonight. If you want, and what you need to do is test on Matt's legs. That sounds extreme, but don't worry. You won't do any more damage to them using standard wrestling moves and submission. Give me all you got. I'm sure I can take it. So, to succeed this match, you need to work Matt's legs at best you can, and then see if you can make him submit. Got it? Work the legs in, go for a submission. No problem, I got one in the bag. What come out first this time? Where's his magnitude facts? Work on max legs and go for a leg submission. No problem. Where's my sharpshooter? Have they taken it away or something? Gonna submit. Oh, he was close. He's gonna submit. Yep. Dang it, I should have submit to my sharpshooter, but it didn't want me to, so I guess it did won't want me to use it. You tapped out! You tapped out! Okay guys, that'll do in case anything happens here. Let me build this up. Alright guys, I'll be back with another part of Sore Mode.